Now we're in Daniel chapter 2, verse 3. Reading from the Interlineal Bible, a direct translation, not worrying about English sentence structure. To know my spirit and is anxious, I have had a dream, the king to them, and said, the dream. Now reading from the King James Bible, quote, and the king said unto them, I have dreamed a dream, and my spirit was troubled to know the dream, unquote. Now let's compare that with the Young's Literal Translation, quote, and the king saith to them, I dream, I have dreamed, and moved is my spirit to know the dream, unquote. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the parsing of this verse. Now let's see what we can find out from parsing this from the Hebrew to see what we have here. This is one time that looking at the Hebrew and parsing it out and trying to understand it is going to help us understand what is transpiring in this that Daniel is relating. Because the Hebrew has certain ways of saying things that the English just do not convey. So let's go forward. And the king said, so let's parse this out so we get a full understanding of what's happening. It's a quail stem, so it's a casual and it's an imperfect aspect. So it's casually said and it's not finished yet. He said, unto them, I have dreamed. And let's look at that. The Hebrew word for I have dreamed is quail stem. So it's a simple casual. And it's a perfect aspect, which means it's completed. So he's casually telling them, I have dreamed a dream. And my spirit was troubled. So let's parse out the word trouble and see how he's coming across there. It's an aphiel stem, which is passive of the quail, so it's a passive casual action. And it's imperfect, which means that it's not done yet. So he is just being casual about telling you that I have this dream and I was troubled. And then to know, this is also a quail stem. So it is just a simple casual action. And it's an infinitive, which means ing. So I just want to know. So the dream. So he's being casual about it right now. He's not upset, nothing. I just want to know. And that's where we are with this parsing. Now, as you can see that in the further verses, that the king is started out to be very casual about this. It's not really a big deal. I have done this because he's expecting the people he has called to tell him what he wants to know because he has assembled them all. The commentators are going all over the place on this as though the king knew what his dream was and wasn't willing to tell the wise men and all of them so that he could test them. And then another one says that the king was so bothered by this because, you know, God gave him the dreamer dreams and that he needs to find out what to do. Did we get any of this from this verse at all? At all? Did we get anything at all from this verse? This is highly speculative. This is why discovering the scriptures was started. So that we can get the truth from the scriptures, present the truth to everyone, myself included, to look at the verse and see what does it mean? What does it mean in context? And then find out for ourselves what we got going on here. None of these commentaries are on the money about this, as we can see. Now, let's go ahead and read this in context, and then we'll go ahead and close this out. Reading from the King James Bible, quote, and in the second year of the reign of Nebuchadnezzar, Nebuchadnezzar dreamed dreams, wherewith his spirit was troubled, and his sleep brake from him. Then the king commanded to call the magicians, and the astrologers, and the sorcerers, and the Chaldeans, for to show the king his dreams. So they came and stood before the king. And the king said unto them, I have dreamed a dream, and my spirit was troubled to know the dream. Unquote. Now notice that in Daniel 2:1, it says Nebuchadnezzar dreamed dreams, plural tense. And down here in 2:3, he says, I have dreamed a dream. So it's going from plural tense up here down to singular tense that the king is saying. So does the king know and trying to test these guys or what? I don't see where that is being presented at all from Daniel. It doesn't say that, and I can't speculate on that. So for right now, we know that the king is casually telling these guys, this is what's happened, and that's all we know so far. So until we go further on into this chapter, let's see. Remember to pray and ask God to give you insight every time you go to study the scripture and meditate upon it as you go throughout the day. May God richly bless you, and please keep praying for myself that I can go ahead and get these verses out with knowledge and wisdom from God and in good health. Thank you, and God bless.